Good evening and welcome to Wednesday Night Online. I'm excited to be here to welcome you this evening. Give me a thumbs up or give me an excited emoji in the comment section, or maybe even type how excited you are to join us this evening for Wednesday Night Online. We're regathering now, so I invite you back to church. We have two services, one at 8:30 a.m. and one at 10:30 a.m. on Sunday morning. Now, let's turn it over to Derek as he leads us in tonight's song.
Children, and don't let us fall by the side of the road. Teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place in our hearts. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down, and I know He's mine forever. In my heart, you gotta walk on through temptation, 'cause His love and His wisdom will be our helping hand. I know the truth, and His word will be our salvation. So lift up our hearts to be thankful and glad. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down, and I know He's mine. Oh yes, He is. Deep down in my soul, Jesus is mine. Oh yes, He is. He won't let you down, and I know forever, in my heart. Help me sing, heart, heart. Ooh, yes. And I know, oh, His love's the power. His love's the glory, forever
and ever.
Oh yeah. Oh
yeah.
Oh yeah. Who can bring you love wherever it leads? And I don't mind, because I hope you don't mind. I'm gonna talk with you and walk with you, do all the things you call me to do, because I know that Jesus
is love.
His love, I know.
And if you ask,
I'll show.
Love is the word.
And ever, who can bring you love?
Jesus.
Who can bring you joy?
Jesus.
Who can turn that old life around?
Jesus.
Oh, ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
All. Hey, hey.
Yeah.
Give him the praise.
Yeah.
Give him the honor.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know that who can heal your body,
Jesus.
Who can make it strong,
Jesus.
Who can help you hold out,
Jesus.
A little while longer. Jesus wants you. You can call him.
Jesus.
He'll answer.
Jesus.
Call him in the morning.
Jesus.
In the
oh.
evening. Hey, hey.
Yeah.
We
yeah.
give you honor.
Yeah.
You're the answer for the ills of the world. Yes, you are. Oh, yes, you are.
Thank you, Derek, for that wonderful message and song. Let's prepare our hearts to receive the word of the Lord. Let's pray. God, thank you for music, for Derek, as he's led us tonight. We pray, God, that you would be with Brother Doug as he preaches and gives us the message from Psalm 23. We ask that you would open our hearts to receive your word, and it's in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Welcome to Wednesday Worship. Have you ever made the mistake of leaving the lights on in your car for an extended period of time, and as a result, your battery ran down? When you return to your car, your headlights may have been on, but they were dim rather than bright. That's because your battery was not functioning at full capacity. Your battery may not have been dead, but it needed to be recharged. One of the wonderful benefits of engaging in Bible study on Wednesday evening is that it provides us with a great opportunity to recharge our spiritual batteries. As most of you know, all the stresses and struggles we face in life can be so draining. We're living in some of the most stressful days we've ever encountered. The coronavirus, economic uncertainty, and civil unrest are taking a toll on all of us. It is easy during these difficult days to become disturbed, disappointed, distressed, distraught, as well as depressed. While the enemy wants to hold us down, the Lord wants to help us up. I pray that the Lord will use tonight's Bible study to recharge your spiritual batteries. With this thought in mind, I want to direct your attention to one of the most personal and practical passages of Scripture found in the Old Testament. I'm referring to the 23rd Psalm. We spent the last 3 months studying the contents of this familiar chapter, which begins with these words. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. Thy rod and Thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. We are currently studying verse 5, which states, Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. In recent weeks, we looked at what David meant when he referred to the table, my enemies, and his head being anointed with oil. Tonight, I want us to focus on the last line of this verse where David wrote, My cup runneth over. The logical question one might ask upon reading this line is, what did David mean when he wrote the words, My cup runneth over? Well, simply stated, David was referring to God's generosity. As he looked back over the course of his life, David was reminded of how God had always been there for him and how God had always more than met his needs. He began this psalm with the declaration, The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. When he comes to verse 5, David builds on the foundation he laid in verse 1 by asserting that in addition to how the good shepherd had met all of his needs, the Lord had provided so much more. In fact, David's cup was not merely full, but instead was running over. Let's look this evening at the word cup. The term cup in this verse is a reference to life. An empty cup symbolized an empty life, while a full cup was indicative of a life that was filled with meaning and blessings. David's testimony was that he had been the recipient of God's great generosity to the extent that his cup was not only filled, but was running over. It is important to note not only what this verse was saying, but also what it is saying. Simply stated, what God had done for David is symbolic of what the Good Shepherd wants to do for any and all of his sheep. Sadly, far too many people attempt to fill their lives with things other than what the Lord desires for them. Some try to fill their lives with the things this world has to offer. One notable biblical character who made this mistake was David's son Solomon. The introductory chapters of the book of Ecclesiastes describe Solomon's attempt to fill his life with position, prosperity, projects, people, and pleasure. Listen to Solomon's testimony. I denied myself nothing my eyes desired. I refused my heart no pleasure. My heart took delight in all my labor, and this was the reward for all my toil. Yet, when I surveyed all that my hands had done and what I had toiled to achieve, everything was meaningless. A chasing after the wind, nothing was gained under the sun. Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verses 10 and 11. This testimony reminds me of an experience I had this past week. I was pouring tea into a red Solo cup. As I did so, I realized the cup was not filling up. Much to my surprise, I saw there was tea all over the table beneath the cup I was holding. My first thought was that something was wrong with either my eyesight or my coordination. How in the world had I managed to make such a mess? Then as I looked closer, I saw that the problem was neither my vision or my coordination. Instead, the cup was leaking. It had a half-inch split near the bottom of the cup. As a result of this leak, I was not able to fill up my cup. Well, this is an illustration of what happens when we try to fill our lives with things that have no eternal value. Regardless of how many worldly things we pour into our lives, we will never experience a true filling or fulfillment. Several years ago, the Eagles released a song entitled, Hole in the World. It begins with these lyrics. There's a hole in the world tonight. There's a cloud of fear and sorrow. There's a hole in the world tonight. Don't let there be a hole in the world tomorrow. Well, it seems to me that there is a hole in the world tonight. We see evidence of this all around us. That's why so many people are angry, frustrated, and fearful. The problem is that this hole can never be filled with the things of this world. The only way there's not going to be a hole in the world tomorrow is for people to fill their lives with Jesus today. At the moment when we are born again, when we are saved, when we invite Jesus into our lives, He comes in through the presence of the Holy Spirit. In Ephesians 5:18, Paul states that believers are to be filled with the Spirit. That is, we are to give the Lord access to every area of our lives. When this happens, we will begin, perhaps for the first time, to experience and be aware of the great generosity of God. We will then be able to say with David, My cup runneth over. Let's pray. Father, thank You that because of Jesus, our lives don't have to be empty. Instead, our lives can be filled, fulfilled, fruitful. And thank You, Lord, that You bless us in so many ways that our cup runs over. We have been the recipient of so many of Your blessings, Lord. Forgive us for taking those blessings for granted, and help us today just to pause and reflect upon Your great generosity and be reminded of those things You do for us each and every day. I pray, Lord, that we would demonstrate an attitude of gratitude this week and just be thankful to You, Lord, for being so good to us. For it's in the name of Jesus I pray. Amen.
Thank you for joining us for Wednesday Night Online. If you have any questions about First Baptist Church, or if you would like to make a decision to make Christ your personal Lord and Savior, go to our website, www.fbcnatchez.org. Click on the Welcome tab, fill out the connection card, let us know if you have any questions and how we can serve you and help you, or maybe even pray for you. We miss you guys, we hope to see you soon, and we'll see you next time on Wednesday Night Online.